In general, the effects of security gaps are not initially felt. The danger only arises once an attacker exploits the security gap. We can distinguish between two main dangers. Firstly, industrial espionage, where an attacker might steal a PLC program, for example, in order to recreate a machine. And secondly, sabotage, where the effects depend on the respective plant or machine.
Fatal sein. Also generell sehe ich keine spezifischen Lücken.
There are no specific gaps in industry. They are the same gaps that you can find in the office IT world. Having said that, the industrial environment is years behind office IT. This means that we need to contend with gaps that were rectified long ago in office IT. Many devices and components like plant and machinery are insecure by design. In other words, security was not considered during development. However, the greatest danger is social engineering, where the attacker tries to manipulate specific users so that they will hand over confidential data or grant access to the industrial network.
Dadurch entstehen dann hauptsächlich die Probleme.
We can distinguish between two technical solutions. Firstly, measures around the device, such as a firewall, for example, to remedy attacks at network level. And secondly, other measures within the devices, such as authorizing user actions. The solution you choose depends on what you want to achieve, but some can only be implemented directly within the devices. Long term, we should bear in mind that security is a moving target. This means that security is not a physical parameter. That is why attackers are constantly developing new technologies, or well-known algorithms are exposed as insecure. So the software on devices must be updated. The challenge is to design the software so that a new safety approval is not due on each occasion, either during manufacture or when in the possession of the customer. At PILZ, we are working on making our product secure by design. This means that security is considered over the whole product lifecycle, starting with a threat analysis to identify first the threats that could negatively impact a component, followed by the implementation of measures to counter these threats. This may either be a measure within the product in the form of a security function, or as instructions to the customer, which must then be implemented in the customer's environment to ensure that use of the product is secure.